This is Ever New with Word Inquiry and I am Tahir. Topic under discussion today in plant breeding and genetics is floral biology. So let us discuss it in detail. First of all, we say what is actinomorphic flower and zygomorphic flower. Flowers with radial symmetry means that can be cut into two by various means, by various ways. It's called actinomorphic flowers, while zygomorphic flowers are having bilateral symmetry. That means can be cut into two equal laterally, like human being. The example in plants is legumes. Then now let us discuss about the, so if one more point about the flower, if flower is single, then is called solitary flower, and flower in group, yeah, bunch, is called inflorescence. Now next part of flowers. Flower consists of two parts mainly, pedicle, pedicel, and then whorl. What is pedicel? Pedicel is an attachment of a single flower with inflorescence. It is derived from Latin words pediculus, pediculus, which means little foot. Now what is whorl? Whorl is the part of flower which is, you can say, circular part. It's also consists of calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium, having all four parts. Flower is known as complete flower, otherwise it is incomplete with missing any one of them. Now let us discuss about calyx. Unit of calyx is sepals, SEPALS. Calyx, what is calyx? Yes, one point in case of pedicle, if the attachment is not with flower, means pedicel, the flower is called as sessile flower, S-E-S-S-I-L-E. This sessile flower. Then now let's come towards calyx. Calyx is included in accessory parts of flower. There are two accessory parts, calyx and corolla, collectively called accessory parts. Why accessory? These are also called as vegetative part. So they said accessory because they assist flower, assist to flower in their working. What's flower? What's flower is used in pollination and fertilization. It is the sex organ of the plant. And these two parts, calyx and corolla, are accessory, and the other two, androtium and gynoecium, are called as necessary or essential parts. So once again, come towards calyx. It is the first outermost layer or circular part of flower. Sepals are its units. If it's green, then it's perform photosynthesis. It's also protect the internal whorl or parts of flower. Then what are its types? It is gamospalous and polypetalous. Gamospalous and polyspalous. When we say gamospalous, mean sepals are united, and when we say polyspalous, means sepals are free. The example of polyspalous is brassica. So this was about sepals. Now let's move towards corolla. What is corolla? So one thing about the floral or flower, if it's contain chromoplast. Chromoplast is a plast containing subpigments which attracts insects for pollination. Chromoplast having the pigments, all type of pigments except the green. So next is in corolla. It is the second whorl or part surround in under the after calyx. Its single unit is petal. Calyx and corolla collectively called perianth. Corolla shapes are capillionaceous. It's irregular but in fly shape. Then bilabiate, divided into two. Similarly funnel shape. Then silver form with narrow tube. Then it is squared, and the last one is campanulate shape, means bell shape. These are the types of corolla. Shapes of you can see. And next is corolla it is polypetalous or gamopetalous, same as was sepals. If it is polypetalous, then sepals are free, and if gamopetalous, petals are fused. Petals are also dicot or monocot. If are monocot, then they are arranged into three or six manners, or multiplication of three. And in case of dicot, the petals are multiplication of four or five. So this was all about the carpal. Next, let's move towards androecium. So this is the third valve, yeah, you can say third part of flower, which is androecium. It is the male organ, or you can say male reproductive organ. Main part of androecium or single unit, you can say stamen. Stamen is what is stamen? It is pollen producing organ. The flower having both staminate and pistillate organs are called perfect flowers or bisexual flower. If there is only a staminate, then it's called unisexual flower. Parts of stamens are anther and filament. Anther is pollen producing part, while filament attached and spore to anther. Then next is, this was all about androecium, and now let's move towards gynoecium. So one thing more, the flower having both androecium and gynoecium are also called as hermaphrodite flower. And these two words are called necessary words, as you can say essential part of flower or essential word. So now let's move towards gynoecium. Gynoecium is the female reproductive organ. Pistil is main, its main unit. When only pistillate flowers, means having only pistil, not stamen, then it's called unisexual. Having three parts, ovary style stigma. Ovary is a smaller portion, contain ovules. Then next is stigma that connects ovary with style connect the ovary with the stigma, and then stigma which is the pollen attracting tip. This was all about pistil. So now move further informations about pistil. They are hypogynous, epigynous and perigynous. If they are hypogynous, mean ovary superior, mean above the carpal. Its example mustard. And then epigynous mean ovary inferior, mean below the carpal. And then the last is perigynous. In this case, ovary is half inferior. Example rose. The epigynous examples are cucumber and guava. So this was all about the flower biology.
further details with reference to flora biology is estivation. What is it? It is the arrangement of sepals and petals. This is velvet shape, twisted, imbricate, quinesial, and then last one, vexillary. Velvet shape, their sepals and petals simply touch, not overlap. This type of shape, example is Calotropis. Then in case of twisted, arrangement of sepals and petals, their margin, they overlap each other. This type of example Chinese rose, ladyfinger, and cotton. Over cotton crop consists in twisted estivation. Remember, the next is imbricate. There is overlapping, but not direction from, mean irregular. This type, its example cassia, and then next is Q-U-I-R-N-E, quincarial, C-A-R-I-C-I-E-L. This type of estivation is upper to inner. Then two inner, two outer, and one twisted. This type of, its example Megaria, Myria, M-Y-A-R-I, Myaria. Then last one is vexillate, vexillary, V-A-X-I-L-L-A-R-Y. Vexillary estivation is, there are five petals, upper two standards, they cover all others and overlap. Further two are wings, they also cover the last one, which is called quills. So this example you can quote in shape of peas and beans. This was all about estivation. Now further explanation about the androecium. Androecium, which is the male organ, reproductive organ, its types are monoadelphous and diadelphous. When we say monoadelphous, it is united in one group. When we say diadelphous, united in two groups. Example of diadelphous is P. Then polyandrous and polyadelphous. When we say polyandrous, their stamens are free. And we say polyadelphous, then stamens are united in several groups. Its example is bamboo. Then next is about the gynoecium, which is the female reproductive organ of the flower gynoecium. Its types are monocarpellary, simcarpus, multicarpellary, so monocarpellary, they are single carpel, example P. And then simcarpus, fused carpels, example mustard. Then next is multicarpellary. There are carpels multiple, means several, example strawberry. Then apocarpellary, there free carpels are free, example lotus. Then this was about the androecium, and the last one is inflorescence, bunch of flowers. Its types are racemos and cymos. Racemos, there the it's called indefinite, where peduncle, what is peduncle? Peduncle is the floral axis. Their movement, there is indefinite, means it's non-stop at the tip of apical. There's no flower, so the arrangement of flowers is bassipetial type. Bassipetial mean the older flowers are at the top, whereas cymos, it is definite because at the terminal apical there is found a flower, so it is also called a discontinuous growth, while as racemos is continuous growth. So there it is flower arrangement is in acropetal way, means younger flowers are at the apex, and it's definite type. This was all about floral biology. Thank you.